Good evening. A woman is dead and two others have been stabbed after a young man armed with a butcher's knife went on a rampage through the heart of Sydney. The CBD came to a standstill, gripped by the lone wolf, allegedly yelling terrorist slogans. And then some ordinary men stepped forward, heroically chasing, cornering and capturing the attacker.
Is that chick all right?
He's gone.
Look. Is that lady okay?
His hands are gone.
The attacker, his head boxed in by a milk crate, his body pinned to the ground, the chairs grabbed from a cafe.
You rat!
And all around, police, firemen and members of the public who took him down. Further up near King Street, one of his alleged victims.
He stabbed a lot.
He stabbed many people. Stabbed many. King Street everywhere.
A woman near the hotel CBD was stabbed in the back. She was conscious as she was treated by paramedics. The body of another woman was found nearby, and another woman walked into Rocks Police Station, her arm wrapped in a scar. Minutes before, this was the man armed with a bloodied knife further south near King Street. At one stage, a member of the public, armed with nothing more than a chair, approaches him.
He had a balaclava on, jumped on a car, wielding the knife with blood on it, and we're like, wow, what is going on here?
As the man moves down the street, Paul O'Shaughnessy and his brothers gave chase.
Continued to chase the guy, where other people were just kind of like going away because obviously he's wielding a knife. Like, I don't know whether it's an instinct thing or what, but we was like, right, we just got to kind of try and restrain this guy from doing any more. And my brother and I just ran across here. These boys followed and we managed to get a grip along with another guy, and we've got a grip of him and restrained him fully.
The O'Shaughnessy brothers show enormous courage, preventing the man from attacking again.
He's got blood all over him and no stabbings on himself, so, you know, there's obviously something's happened. So for us, it was just about restraining him, getting the police here, but my brother, he was the hero, he got a grip of him. And
the O'Shaughnessy brothers were also helped by this man.
I followed him up York Street and trying to get him to focus on me rather than focus on anyone else around him, so that he didn't, because there's lots of pedestrians there and I didn't want him to sort of lash out at them. I wasn't scared, I just wasn't really focused on that, I was more focused on what I was doing, so it was more about...
You're a hero, thank you.
No, thanks.
Eyewitnesses say when he was caught, he was yelling Allah Akbar. He wasn't on the ground for long. Police cuffed and marched the attacker away. Block after block near the scene, the shock was setting in.
A little shaken up. But, you know, it's not something you expect to see in Sydney.
One man armed with a knife and many crime scenes. Everyone who laid eyes on him said he looked crazed, deranged and out of control. The question now for police is to try and determine what drove him to carry out this rampage. At one stage, the knife man jumped on Leon Banglani's car. He said he looked fearless.
Anything could have happened if I had the windows down, what if he came in, went for me, because the knife was, it's a big scary knife in his hand.
There are questions about the motive and the exact circumstances surrounding those who were attacked. But there is no doubt about the bravery of a group who chased and caught him.
Their actions clearly have prevented other people being hurt.
I would agree with that. Again, these people, these members of the public, going about their day-to-day business, have jumped into a situation which was extremely dangerous, extremely hostile, and they have brought a person who we will be alleging has stabbed an innocent person for no specific reason.
Damien Ryan, Nine News.
And we're learning more about the suspect at the centre of this rampage tonight. Hannah Sinclair, what can you tell us?
Tomo, police have locked down Mertney's family home here in Maryong in Sydney's west, and tonight it is a crime scene. Police say this man was not on any terror watch list and that he acted alone, but that he has terrorist ideologies. Police say they're investigating whether he absconded from a mental health facility just a few days ago. Now, I spoke to a few neighbours out here and they told me that he lived at the property behind me here with his sister and his mother, and that he was always very quiet. His family tonight are with relatives. Detectives have just arrived on scene, but at this stage, it's unclear whether they will raid the property. Tomo.
Hannah, thank you for the update.